everyone. Thanks for joining me. Welcome to Reptile Ridge. We begin this episode with a visit to the garden, where I find Rosie, the anole. Today, it is she and not the skink who rules the roost, this old birdhouse. As I pan out across the turtle pond, you can see in the garden the only thing blooming this time of the year is the oleander. Meanwhile, over here at my gardening station, the skink is enjoying a ripped-up bag of potting soil. I wonder who could have done that. Oh, I think I know. Blame it on the usual suspects. This, my friends, is a beautiful animal. Just take a look at those gorgeous iridescent colors and that strikingly lovely neon blue tail. I'm just a few feet from her. She knows I'm here. It's almost as if she's posing for the camera. Oh well, guess that's it. She's done with the paparazzi. Looks like Rosie's had enough as well. Besides, it's beginning to rain again. After the rain showers end, I go back out to find Rosie creeping around in the oleander. With all the moisture and humidity in the air, Rosie is beginning to molt. She's starting to shed her skin at the base of her tail. Molting, or shedding of the skin, is quite common in reptiles. Most of them do it. It's just a good sign that they're healthy and growing. The process doesn't take very long, and before you know it, she has beautiful, baby soft, newly exfoliated skin. Gee, I wish I could do that. Sure would save a lot of money on all those face creams. Oh well, it's like they say, beauty is only skin deep. It's what's on the inside that matters. And moving right along, it's time to check in with the backyard anoles, beginning with this one. This is the area once ruled by the dominant male anole, Bruce, and his mate, Stubby. However, neither of them have been seen in quite some time. Back here is a very dangerous place to be an anole. And there's one reason why. As a matter of fact, there are 11 of them, all with very, very sharp claws. Those old dried plant stalks are a great way for the cats to keep those claws in pristine condition, just right for grabbing a hold to prey. Pray that it won't be one of the anoles. Cats, dogs, and other predators are all just a fact of life for the anoles, just something that they have to be aware of and look out for at all times. Through the garden and across the yard we go, over to the woods where the woodpile is, and where the anole, known as Rico, once roamed. As I search the trees, I'm seeing only females. Strangely, it seems no matter where I go throughout the yard, all the males appear to be missing. After the height of the spring breeding season, all the dominant males disappear. Just where do they go exactly? Well, that's a question I'm going to try to answer for you. There are many different reasons anoles go missing in action. One may simply be just to rest and relax after a hectic breeding season. But sometimes, they disappear due to way more ominous reasons. All we can do is watch and wait to see who will return and who will not. I hope you guys will return for the next episode. Thanks for watching.